So, what is this place? Church. It's a church. This is the alley, but this entire building is a church. So we have church here on a Sunday, 9 a.m. and 10:30, and 6 p.m. So you've got three options. Come to all three, if you want.
Indeed.
Which is super cool. And the last thing is, everyone just start a clap.
Man, shout out to Amy and Josh, always holding it down. Tribal Wars, man, that looks really ass, but who's excited for tonight? I'm excited. Man, that's just beginning, honestly. But tonight, I'm going to be pretty quick. I'll just get straight to the point. But how I like to speak is I like to, I can actually see everyone. So you can see me. Who can see me? Who can see my face? Yep, so I can see you as well. And I like to call out people who are on Instagram and Facebook, and I use you in my stories. Not you won't be the good guy, you'll be like the bad guy and stuff. So that's just the shots fired. That's how I roll, you know? So if I hear you, you know, talking to your girlfriend or something, I'll call you out. But awesome, how about we break? How about this? I mean, that's an awesome way to start. How about we just close our eyes real quick? Lord, we thank you for tonight, God. We thank you just for all the fun we can have at Tribal Wars, God. But right now, God, we just for these, you know, few minutes, God, we just fix our focus on you, God. You know, we just, you know, turn off distractions, God. We just put our eyes on you tonight, God. Lord, we may have had a crap week, God. We may have, you know, had an average, you know, time at school, God. We may be going through some things, God. But Lord, right now, I pray you speak to all of us, God. Lord, I pray you speak into our situations, God, and you speak through me tonight. Everyone said, amen. Awesome. So, 2 weeks ago, who remember what happened 2 weeks ago at youth? Stadium 9. That was so lit. So we had HWK and Ben McGonagall with us, bringing the word. I mean, that was lit. That was so good. And, you know, that was an awesome night. But that Friday, for me, started off pretty average. So I recently got, a couple of months ago, I got a phone. An iPhone. And that morning, I cracked my iPhone. And honestly, it was, who's got a cracked iPhone or like phone? Yeah, the struggle's real, eh? The struggle is real. Honestly, I was so gutted. So this is how it happened, right? This is how it went down. This is how I cracked my iPhone. You probably can't see it, but it's cracked. So this is what happened, right? I don't like telling people this, but I'm gonna just tell you guys tonight. So what happened? As I'm a uni student, go to Massey University. If you're thinking about going to uni, go to Massey. It's the best uni out. So Friday morning, right, I've got a lecture at 9 a.m. And I was running a little bit late. It was about 2 minutes late. And if you remember, that was a really wet day. So you remember the rain. It was just like bucketing down. So I, you know, kind of parked up, got out my car, kind of like sprinted to the building. That's how I run. So I got to the building, right? And obviously I'm like, you know, soaking wet. And I get in, you know, the building, and my class is on the bottom level. So I have to go down some stairs. But I didn't realize, well, I just didn't think that my shoes are slippery as well. So I'm about to go down these stairs, right? And I'm just like, I'm like, look at my phone, So I got my phone, this is how it happened. I cracked my phone. Alright, so I look at my phone, it's like, oh man, I'm like 2 minutes late. And you don't want to be like the last person in like to your class, because it's always real awkward at uni. Like people just look at you. It's like, oh, he's mad again, late. And so I kind of, you know, I was coming down the stairs. Can you guys see me? I'm not actually going to fall because I don't want to break my neck or something. But like, I was coming down the stairs and I was kind of late, so I kind of like had to do like the half pace, but still, you know, swag, kind of run. So I was coming down and about two steps down, I just lose it, eh? My foot goes up like this. My other foot goes up like this. And I just land on my sweaty bum. And honestly, I didn't just go bang, I went bang, 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 bang. Like, honestly, it was still steps. And it was like the loudest thing, you probably heard it in Africa. It was like the loudest noise you'll ever hear. And I'm just lying there, reflecting on life. I was like, well, I didn't decide to come to uni this morning. And I'm just lying there, and I was like, and it was triggered. I was like, man, I hope no one saw that. And I look up, and I'm sort of lying down on my bed, and there's at least 50 people waiting outside the class. And I'm just like, oh my gosh, oh my gosh. And then like, you know at school, like how if you do something embarrassing, people just laugh at you? Like no one's got a filter. And so I was just like, but I was hoping like people at uni are a bit more, you know, mature than that. And I was like, oh man, I hope these guys are like gonna come up to me and be like, bro, are you okay? I'm here for you. But that didn't happen. So I look up, I made eye contact with this guy, one of the 50 people there. And he looks at me, it's almost like it happened in slow motion. I looked up, he raises his arm, he points at me, he's like, ah! And then like, all his boys around him are like, ah! And they're like, honestly, like, it sparks up everyone, everyone's just like, ah! And I was just like, oh my gosh, can this day get any worse? And I'm just lying there, and I have to get up. So I have to get up, and literally I walk down the stairs, and everyone's just like, getting hyped, just looking at me, and I'm just like, you know, that meme's like, hello darkness, my, you know, that was like going through my head. And like, I was just walking, and I literally had to do the walk of shame past all these guys waiting to get into their class. And I'm just like, oh my gosh, this is so awkward. And like, yeah, I got to my class, and I was just like, you know, and I thought that was the worst bit, you know, having to walk past them, the walk of shame, I thought that was the worst bit. Look at my phone, realize I fully cracked it, and I'm just like, oh man, this sucks. This actually sucks. But that was my Friday morning, and then it got better as the night went on. Stadium night, that was lit. But, you know, tonight, I kind of want to talk about, you know, how we've all made mistakes, and, you know, we've all probably done stuff that we're ashamed of, and, you know, which results in us thinking that maybe we had to do our own walk of shame, you know, or thinking that I can't come to church, or I can't be a Christian because I'm not good enough, you know, but tonight, I want to talk about how Jesus has already done the walk of shame for us. He's already stood in that place. And you know, when Jesus was about to be crucified, you know, for our sins, he was beaten up so bad that he became unrecognizable. He was whipped 40 times and beaten up. And after they did that to him, they made him get up, and you had to walk around about 500 meters to the cross where they were going to crucify him. And, you know, as he was walking, you know, he was, you know, he would have been bleeding to death from, you know, the 40 lashes on his back and them beating him up. And you can just imagine the people on the side of the road laughing at him. You know, this perfect dude who came to stand in our place, being embarrassed like that. And You know, but by him doing that, you know, he didn't just die on the cross for our sins. You know, he died on the cross for our shame as well. And, you know, he was embarrassed and shamed upon that day, so that we don't have to feel embarrassed or ashamed when we come to God or when we come to youth, because he's already taken our place. He's already filled the gap so that we can be forgiven and live in freedom and live in that place where we know God's, you know, God's grace has covered us. And so I want to bring you guys to Romans 8 verse 38. Who's got their Bibles tonight? Also, like one person. Who's got their Bibles on their phone? Yeah, there we go, there we go, there we go. All right, so I want you guys to turn to Romans 8, verse 38. If you got it, just if you don't have a Bible, just pretend to like reach down and like pick up your invisible Bible. And then when you've got, you know, when you've turned to your invisible page, say invisible. So Romans 8, verse 38, the NIV version. All right, so it goes like this. For I am convinced that neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither the present nor the future, nor any powers, neither height nor depth, nor anything else in all of creation will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus our Lord. And that's such a powerful scripture, man. And what is that saying? You know, that's saying that God can use anyone. You know, God, nothing can separate you from the love of God and the grace of God. No matter what you've done, no matter what your past looks like, he can still use you. And you see throughout the Bible that God used some messed up people to change the world. Like, honestly, he used the most messed up people to change the world, radically changing their lives and so they can actually change the world and help people. And, you know, he used prostitutes. He used murderers. Like, how crazy is that? And, you know, it doesn't matter if, you know, you're Kanye West or Donald Trump. You know, God can still use anyone. He can use you. And, you know, one example we see in the Bible is this dude called Paul. Who's heard of Paul? Who knows of Paul? Paul at their school? Yeah. Pauls are usually, you know, good dudes. But this guy in the Bible, the original Paul, he was a good dude. You know, he wrote a lot of the Bible. He wrote a lot of the New Testament. Oh, sorry about that. Oh, this is too much water. But back to the topic. Gotta let that slide. He planted, you know, a lot of churches and wrote a lot of the Bible. But you know, before he became a Christian, he was messed up. Like, straight, this is how messed up he was before he became a Christian. Like, he was the OG of ISIS. Like, I'm not even joking. This guy used to kill Christians. What does ISIS do? Kill Christians. Like, this guy was the OG terrorist. Like, straight up, this guy was, like, so many people were scared of this guy because he was trying to hunt down Christians and kill them. And, but God, you know, as he does, he reached out to this guy called Paul. And we read it in Acts 9. If you've got your invisible Bibles with you again, go to Acts 9. Right, so this is when Paul encounters Jesus. It says, meanwhile, Saul was still breathing out murderous threats against the Lord's disciples. He went to the high priest and asked him for letters to the synagogues in Damascus, so that if he found any there who belonged to the way, or Christians, whether men or women, he might take them as prisoners to Jerusalem. As he neared Damascus on his journey, suddenly a light from heaven flashed around him. He fell to the ground and heard a voice say to him, Saul, Saul, So he was, just side note there, he used to be called Saul, and he changed his name to Paul, real original. But so Saul, why do you persecute me? Who are you, Lord? Saul asked. I am Jesus, whom you are persecuting. He replied, now get up and go into the city, and you'll be told what you must do. See, God didn't see Paul's mess. You know, he didn't see his problems. He looked into his potential. And maybe that's you tonight. You know, we've all got our brokenness, and we've all got our dirt. And our dirt, so this is a container of dirt, if you can't see. A lot of dirt in here. I dug this up from my home, so can't wait till my parents see it. No, it was all good. So this is all dirt in here, lots of dirt. So our dirt can be labeled as all the things we're ashamed of. You know, on Instagram, you know, we know the saying, we show the best, but we hide the rest. And, you know, no one takes selfies of their dirt. Have you ever seen someone take a selfie of dirt? Nah. So, we don't take selfies of our dirt. We don't take selfies of our mess because we try to hide that stuff. You know, we try to hide all our problems. You know, because we think that we'll be labeled by our mistakes. You know, we think that people will label us by all our dirt. And no, sometimes we try and cover that dirt by, you know, getting drunk, you know, the drugs, you know, the bad relationships, the porn. I'm just being real with you guys tonight. You know, sometimes we try to cover that. You know, we're trying to cover our shame. You know, but all that, you know, that is doing is just adding more dirt to our lives. You know, the only way that you can take away your shame, you know, the only way that you can be healed is by the grace of God. The only way you can be changed is by the grace of God. Nothing else can take your shame away. You know, no quick fix, no drug, you know, no drink can take your problems away. You know, but if we say yes to God, you know, if we allow Him to reach into our lives, you know, if we allow Him to take hold of our dirt, you know, He can reach in and pull out our purpose. Because God doesn't see your dirt, He sees your potential. And in His Word, He says you are fearfully and wonderfully made, made for a reason, created in the image of God. You know, you're on this planet for a purpose. And God wants to bring something out of you that the world hasn't seen yet. Something unique that can impact your family, that can impact your school, and that can impact this nation. And this, I want everyone to join in this, so I just keep your eyes shut and repeat after me. Dear God,
thank you
for dying on the cross for me. Thank you for forgiving my sins. Lord, tonight I choose to follow you for the rest of my life. Show me my purpose. Show me your will for my life. And everyone said, amen. Let's give it up for all those guys who put up their hand. That's so cool. Honestly, there's a party in heaven tonight. But right now, I'm going to hand it back to Pastor Claire. Give it up for Pastor Claire.
Sneaky man. All right, so baptism people, stay here. If you're keen about baptism, stay here.